Learn about IFI for the T-log and other things on Purvi's list this week on Data Exposed. Hi, I'm Anna Hoffman, and welcome to this episode of Data Exposed. Today, I'm joined by Bob Ward. Bob, thanks for coming on.
Back again, yeah.
Back again, and today we're continuing our SQL Server 2022 Hidden Gems series. It's been a wild ride so far, and we've got more. Now, some of these items come from Purvi. Do you want to tell us a little bit about this, how she plays into all this?
Purvi Shah is one of the most amazing people at Microsoft. I meet so many great people at Microsoft that are so talented and special. It's hard to meet a combination of somebody that's talented and special and just so humble. She works on performance for us, and people don't even know she is Purvi Shah. She's an engineer. Her job is just to make SQL faster, and she finds so many incredible ways. So when SQL 2022 was launching, I emailed her saying, Purvi, what's your list? What are things that people don't know about that you put into the product that make it faster? And you see right in front of your screen some of those things. Some are really interesting. The last one caught my eye. Instant file initialization for the transaction log. Like, ever since we've had this feature, we couldn't do this. It wasn't possible.
Yeah.
So I was like, Purvi, what did you do here? What? You can do it even with TDE. And it doesn't even require the privilege, which is required for the data part. So she's like, yeah, this is something I worked on. And I'm like, I'm going to build a demo. So okay. I got to show it to you. You want to see it?
Yeah, let's take a look.
So this is 2019, before her changes. And what I'm going to show you is a combination of how faster we ought to grow the log and a reduction in virtual log files, which helps reduce the fragmentation. She actually put that in as well. So if you look here, you can see that I've got a particular size of data, particular a small log size, and a file growth of 64 meg. That's key to this. Mm-hmm. It needs to be an auto growth of 64 meg or less to make this work, which is fine because she's reduced VLF. So here's a transaction that's going to do a bunch of inserts on a big table. So I'm going to really grow the log a lot pretty easily. So when I kick this off, what I like to do is kind of measure some stuff, wait types and VLFs and so forth. So I've also got X event session set up here. Now I've already run this insert. Notice these what are called preemptive wait file types. This is the operating system call for us to zero the log.
Oh.
So this is before her changes, right?
Mm-hmm.
So every time I have to grow the log, I have to go to the operating system and zero out the whole entire 64 meg. Now the duration of each of these things is not huge, but it adds up over time.
Mm-hmm.
So you know, each time I'm growing the log, I have to go to the operating system and zero this before her changes. So I'm seeing this in here, and you might want to ask yourself, like, what's the overall impact of this? So we're going to look at the duration of this. We're going to look at some wait types and then kind of see what the behavior looks like. So now let's go. You can see every time I'm growing the log, I've got one of these events. So I'm just using X event to show you each time this occurs for a grow, you know, what is actually happening. And that's the actual API call we make into Windows. So if you scroll down over here, I can tell it took about 17 seconds.
Okay.
It's just a demo. It doesn't seem significant,
yeah.
But with our changes, we're going to see that's going to be faster. So a couple things else you can look at here. You can go look at wait types. Notice here that this particular preemptive wait type happens, and it takes about 8 seconds out of the 17. So almost half my time is doing the zeroing of this log file growth operation. Now, VLFs are important, and what she's done is made an improvement here. It took 51 VLFs. Now, it's fragmented in my log. So what I'd like to do is kind of go over in 2022 and see the difference. Let's go do that.
Cool.
So same database, 2022, same scenario. Let's kick it off. Same auto grow, same size. So I've run this insert. Let me go back and, I'm just showing you here. This is my auto grow to make sure you know what you need to set up. So running this, same type of insert. I've already run this command. If you scroll down of here, 7 seconds.
Wow.
Yeah.
So we lost the 8 and then some.
Exactly. And some. So we reduced all of that wait time. And in fact, I can prove it. Look at X event. All those preemptive wait types are now gone because she doesn't have to go call the APIs to zero the log. And there's more. In fact, you can actually kind of prove it, I think, looking at wait types to see, you know, are these wait types particularly gone? Let me scroll over and see that. You can see the duration is just less. It's less duration than it was for each type of grow that I did before. So let's go over and see wait types. Let me scroll up here. Yeah, those are the wait types, right? Now look at this. It's gone. There's no wait types anymore for that write file gather.
Uh-huh.
There are a couple of wait types in here, but it has nothing to do with the log growth we're doing. That was from before for the actual operation of the data. And so what about VLFs? It was 51 VLFs, cut them in half.
Wow.
Based on her algorithms, not just with log autogrow. And that VLF improvement is independent of this IFI type development. So she made two changes that improve this whole log auto grow situation, which is really, really significant. So it's pretty cool technology. I'm pretty impressed what she's done.
Yeah.
This is built into the product. There's no, the only thing you have to do is just go to 2022 and use an auto grow of 64 meg or less.
Got it. And can you give us like some hint, like how did she do this?
Well, here's the problem. See, we couldn't use i5 for the log because we need to make sure the log is presented as zeros to us. So we can see where the tail of log in and log parity correctly. She found out if she actually used 64 meg or less, Windows would do this even if she tried to use this feature. And so she doesn't need the privilege to do it. She doesn't, TDE, it doesn't matter if it's encrypted. She can just do it with the right size. And it was just a work with her, between her and the Windows team, to find this optimization.
Wow, that's amazing.
I know, it's great. She's just an amazing person.
And that's why you said the 64 part is so important.
It is,
to get this.
Yeah.
Awesome, cool, well, Bob.
And you know, guess what? We've enabled this in the cloud.
Really?
Yeah, so if you're a cloud customer, she's just so smart. She's put it in. If you're working in the cloud as well for Azure Database or managed instance, it just works.
Amazing. That's awesome. Well, thanks to Purvi and all of the things that she's done. Certainly a hidden gem, a couple of them. So, Bob, thanks so much for sharing this with us. To our viewers, thanks for tuning in. Hope you found this interesting. I know it's something folks have been asking about for a while. If you like this episode, go ahead, give it a like, leave us a comment, and let us know what you think. And we hope to see you next time on Data Exposed.